2020, the year where if you're not wearing a mask, you're the weird one. The year where no one says bless you anymore, they say, get away from me. While this has been one of the most challenging years of all our lives, I feel it has reminded us of two very important themes, gratitude and perseverance. These are themes that I live my life by and I want to take into my future teaching as well. Through my creative arts learning journey, I was reminded of these themes over and over again. I was reminded of perseverance when my giraffe looked nothing like a giraffe, when salsa went from one small step into a whole routine before my eyes, and I was reminded of gratitude as I learned to move my body in new ways, appreciating every part and accessing information so easily and freely. So now it's time to rip off our proverbial masks and showcase the inner creativity we all possess inside. Please enjoy my learning journey. To make up the 15 hours of my creative arts learning journey, I completed 6 hours in dance, 6 hours in visual arts, and 3 hours in drama. While dancing has never been my strongest attribute, I've never shied away from a cheeky boogie. However, for my dance component on my visual arts learning journey, I decided it was time to put a method to my madness. The first part of my dancing learning journey was through our guided face-to-face classes with Rachel Jacobs. Rachel took us through some warm-ups and techniques such as the mirror dance, which is shown here, that can be applied to all ages of the classroom. The classes helped broaden my knowledge of the elements and components of dance, such as space, direction, and the relationship between the individuals and the group. It was a thoroughly enjoyable experience, and it really showed how with dance education, you can create an inclusive classroom where students are able to fully express themselves through movement, breaking through language barriers and other learning difficulties. For the independent dance component of my learning, I worked with my beautiful fiancée Hayley, who was actually very excited when she found out about this assignment, as she's always wanted to try some dance classes together. We engaged upon learning the basic elements of the waltz, bachata, and salsa. We done this through resources such as YouTube, as well as taking an online class with Latin Dance Australia. This experience again taught us the importance of space, distance, timing, and tempo as we engage in our newfound skills. While dipping our toes in, it also showed us just how much there is to learn. This gave me an insight about how little steps through dance can be transformed into something so much bigger. This is a great learning and teaching experience within the classroom, as students are able to persevere through challenges and see progression within their own dancing. This experience has allowed me to gain an understanding of dance and will help me adapt dance education into my creative arts teaching pedagogy. Through dance, I will encourage students to self-express and communicate their own ideas through body movement. Dance is also an art form that can be integrated with many other subjects such as math, English, and science. The first step to my visual arts journey was to learn to draw. I've always had a keen eye for art, specifically animal art, but I've never attempted to draw my own. I decided to give it a go, drawing the King of the Jungle, and found a YouTube tutorial on how to draw a lion. My first attempt went, From my first attempt, I learned the importance of shape, space, tone, and texture. I decided to add grid lines to the final piece and attempt to draw it again, more symmetrical. In order to add texture to my art, I used HB and 6B pencils when shading. I was quite happy with the result, aside from the fact that my lion's mane looked a bit more like a teenage girl's ponytail rather than a ferocious beast. But when I looked back at how far I was able to go in a relatively short amount of time, I thought of it as a teaching moment to allow future learners to celebrate little wins along the way and strive for progress rather than perfection. I then decided to have a go using watercolour paint. This was my first time using watercolour paint, and through my research learned to focus on the elements of colour, shape, value and edges. Firstly, I decided to try out these elements drawing abstract eucalyptus leaves following a tutorial on YouTube. To keep with the animal theme, I then decided to paint a giraffe. This is where I had to use real perseverance to continue with my art. I wasn't controlling the paint properly, my mix of colours was off, and at one point I looked down and thought about just quitting. At this very moment though, I asked myself, if I were a student in my own classroom, thinking about quitting halfway through a painting, what would I want them to do? To answer with this question, I persevered with my giraffe and decided to finish it off without the use of the tutorial. Yes, My giraffe might not be perfect, but what in the world is? Visual arts is about creation and expression. It's about empowering our students to portray thoughts, memories, and experiences not bound by time or distance barriers. Through visual arts, we can develop superior cognitive development within our students, and in this day and age filled with many visual stimulants, developing our students through visual arts can prepare them for so many other aspects of life. A compass if you know what I mean. Drunk on that nectar of all that. The drama component of my learning occurred during our face-to-face classes with Rachel Jacobs. The class was thoroughly enjoyable, and we addressed elements of drama that fit within the syllabus components of making, performing, and appreciating. We engaged in activities such as the forest walk, which opened my eyes to the powerful nature in drama learning and how you can take students absolutely anywhere through drama education. While I wish I had recorded more aspects of the class, it was a powerful learning experience for myself and my classmates into the potential of drama education. The engaging element of drama education can construct knowledge in a way where it is more easily retained. Teachers can use drama to teach controversial themes such as racism, suicide, bullying, or immigration, as has been showcased in this presentation. My learning experiences through this assignment will help in my development as a future primary school teacher, both within creative arts and beyond. I'm excited to use arts education within my teaching of other subject areas, keeping them engaging for both my students and myself. Furthermore, through this assignment, I've been able to meet elements of graduate teacher standards 2 and 6. As a graduate teacher, I'm expected to meet standard 2, which is to know the content and how to teach it. This assignment has allowed me to demonstrate knowledge and understanding of concepts related to dance, drama, and visual arts. This will hold me in better stead as a future teacher to develop teaching strategies within these areas and contribute in the best way I can to students learning within my classrooms. Graduate teachers are also expected to meet Standard 6, which is to engage in professional learning. Through my arts assignment, I've engaged in professional learning when it came to dance and drama, such as the classes run by Rachel Jacobs, the YouTube videos teaching visual arts, and the dance classes by Aladdin Dance Australia. I am very grateful to have been able to complete my learning through all the art forms and look forward to passing some of my learning on to my future students. Thank you so much for watching.